One of the law of force mentioned before is Hooke's law, a special case of quasi-elastic forces. The law of elasticity was discovered by the English physicist Robert Hooke in 1660. In his experiments with the elastic deformation of different materials, he exerted a force on a material and studied how it stretched or compressed in response to the force. He could apply a deformation force to a solid by stretching, compressing, squeezing, bending, or twisting. Hooke examined elastic deformation, which is reversible and non-permanent. This means that the material returns to its original shape and size upon removal of the load. Hooke noticed that the displacement or the size of the deformation of the material is directly proportional to the applied force for relatively small deformations. In other words, the force or stress versus strain curve for many materials has a linear region within certain limits. In the stress versus strain plot, the green area represents this linear region called elastic zone, where Hooke's law is valid. In the plastic zone represented by the blue area, the deformation of the material becomes non-reversible and permanent. The stress versus strain curve is not linear in the stress hardening zone represented by the yellow area, where it reaches its maximum called strain ultimate tensile strength. The curve decreases in the failure zone represented by the red area and ends at the fracture point of the given material. In order to study Hooke's law, we apply a force or strain small enough so that the deformation of any object remains in the elastic zone. We already gave the mathematical form of Hooke's law stating that the applied or the restoring force F is equal to plus or minus a constant k times the displacement x, that is the change in the length of the deformed body. The plus sign is for the applied force and the minus sign is for the restoring force causing the body to return to its original dimensions. As the law of action and reaction states, the applied and restoring forces are equal and opposite in direction. The value of the constant k, called spring constant, has the unit of Newton per meter, and it depends on the material properties, the dimensions, and the shape of the body. Since we study Hooke's law in the context of the derivation of equations of motion from a law of force, we will apply the example of a body suspended from a spring. Then the law of force states that the restoring force F causing the string to return to its original shape is equal to minus the spring constant K times its displacement X. If we substitute this law of force into the fundamental equation of dynamics, we can obtain the equation of motion of the body and solve it for the displacement x of the body as a function of time. In kinematics, we already presented an experiment set up where an iron cylinder with the mass m is suspended to compensate its gravitational acceleration, and two springs are also attached to the cylinder. Both the springs are fixed at their other end, as seen in the figure. If we orient the x-axis along the axes of the springs where the cylinder is at rest at the origin, then the body can move a short distance along the x-axis in both directions, expanding and compressing the springs. As a result, the springs exert a net restoring force F on the moving body, where the magnitude of the force is proportional to the displacement x of the cylinder and points in the opposite direction of its motion. In this coordinate system, the only non-vanishing component of the force F is in the x direction, and the fundamental equation of dynamics describing the effect of the net force on the cylinder is the following. The mass m of the cylinder times the second order derivative of its displacement x with respect to the time t is equal to the x component of the force F. Here the law of force is given by Hooke's law, that is the x component of the restoring force F acting on the cylinder is equal to minus the spring constant k times the displacement x of the body. The spring constant k represents the total effect of both the springs attached to the cylinder. Then the equation of motion states that the mass m of the body times the second order derivative of the displacement x with respect to the time t is equal to minus k times the displacement x. If we introduce the variable omega squared defined as the ratio of the spring constant k to the mass m, we can write the equation of motion in the form stating that the second order derivative of the displacement x with respect to the time t is equal to minus omega squared times the displacement x. The general solution of this differential equation provides the displacement x function of time, which is equal to a constant c1 times the sine of omega times t, plus a constant c2 times the cosine of omega times t. Here c1 and c2 are the integration constants of the solution to the second order differential equation. The derivative of this equation gives the x component of the velocity v of the body, which is equal to c1 times omega times the cosine of omega times t, minus c2 times omega times the sine of omega times t. The derivative of this equation gives the x component of the acceleration a of the body, which is equal to minus c1 times omega squared times the sine of omega times t, minus c2 times omega squared times the cosine of omega times t. then the x component of the acceleration a of the body is equal to minus omega squared times its displacement x, as seen in the presentation of simple harmonic motion in kinematics. The y and z components of all these kinematic quantities obviously vanish in the one-dimensional motion along the axes of the springs. For the initial value condition at the time t equal to 0 second, we can specify the initial displacement x0 and the x component of the initial velocity v0 of the body. By substituting these values into the general solutions for t equal to 0 second, we can express the integration constants in terms of the initial data. Then we can see that c1 is equal to the ratio of the x component of the initial velocity v0 to omega, and c2 is equal to the initial displacement x0. As a result, the displacement x of the body can be written as the ratio of the x component of its initial velocity v0 to omega, times the sine of omega times the time t, plus the initial displacement x0 times the cosine of omega times the time t. Here the initial data x0 and v0x are arbitrary constant and they uniquely determine the motion of the body for a given omega, that is for a given mass m and a given spring constant k. This equation can be simplified by introducing the new variables a and alpha such that the following two equations hold. The first equation states that the ratio of the x component of the initial velocity v0 to omega is equal to a times cosine alpha, whereas the second one states that the initial displacement x0 is equal to a times sine alpha. These new variables can also be written in terms of the initial data. If we add the squares of these equations together, we can express the variable a as the square root of the sum of x0 squared and the square of v0x divided by omega. If we divide the second equation by the first one, we can express tangent alpha as the ratio of omega times x0 to v0x. By substituting the new variables into the unique solution to the equation of motion, we can write the displacement x as a times cosine alpha times the sine of omega times t, plus a times sine alpha times the cosine of omega times t. The right-hand side of the equation is simply equal to a times the sine of the quantity of omega times t plus alpha. This solution demonstrates that a point mass m performs a simple harmonic motion under the influence of the quasi-elastic force Fx equal to minus k times x, where the displacement x of the point mass is equal to the maximum amplitude a times the sine of the quantity of the angular frequency omega times the time t plus the phase angle alpha. The angular frequency of the oscillation is given by the square root of the ratio of the spring constant k to the mass m, whereas the maximum amplitude a and the phase alpha of the oscillation are determined by the initial conditions for the displacement and the velocity of the body. The period t of the oscillation given by 2 pi over the angular frequency is equal to 2 pi times the square root of the ratio of m to k. We can choose the turning point of the oscillation as the initial displacement x0 of the body, where the x component of its velocity v vanishes, that is the x component of its initial velocity v0 is equal to 0. This is the case where we pull the cylinder right to a given position x0, and let it oscillate between the positions x0 and minus x0. Then the maximum amplitude a is equal to the initial displacement x0 of the body, which can be seen by substituting the vanishing x component of the initial velocity into the expression for a. Similarly, at the turning point the phase angle alpha in the argument of the sine function is equal to pi over 2, or 90 degrees, which can also be seen if we substitute the vanishing initial velocity into the expression for tangent alpha. As a result, the displacement x of the body for the initial position at the turning point is given by the initial displacement x0 times the sine of the quantity of omega times t plus pi over 2, which is equal to x0 times the cosine of omega times t, as the graph shows. In this special case the parameters of the motion are the maximum amplitude a of the oscillation, which is given by the initial displacement x0 of the body, and the angular frequency omega of the motion, which is determined by the ratio of the spring constant k to the mass m of the body. Since the cylinder in this experiment is suspended such that the gravitational force acting on the body is compensated, gravity has no role in its simple harmonic motion. However, if we suspend a body from a spring itself, we have to take into account the gravitational force in the fundamental equation of dynamics. Let us consider a body with a mass m suspended from a spring with a spring constant k, where we hold the body in our hand to compensate the weight of the body and prevent the spring from stretching. Here the position of the body is denoted by the origin O, which is located on the x-axis pointing downwards. If we release the body then it will stretch the spring and it starts to oscillate around the origin O bar, where the distance between the points O and O bar is given by the mass m times the magnitude of the gravitational acceleration g divided by the spring constant k. We can describe this behavior by supplementing the force term in the fundamental equation of dynamics with the gravitational force acting on the body. That is, the x component of the force F in the equation is equal to the spring constant k times the displacement x of the body given by Hooke's law, plus the mass m of the body times the magnitude of the gravitational acceleration g due to the gravitational force. As a result, the equation of motion for the body suspended from the spring is the following. Its mass m times the second order derivative of its displacement x with respect to the time t is equal to minus k times x, plus m times g, which is equal to minus k times the quantity of x minus m times g divided by k. If we introduce the variable x bar defined by x minus m times g divided by k, then the equation of motion states that the second order derivative of the variable x bar is equal to minus omega squared times x bar. Here omega squared is still defined by the ratio of k to m. This is the same equation as the equation of motion describing the horizontal harmonic motion of the cylinder, and the only difference is that the displacement x bar measured from the origin O bar. Then the solution to this equation states that x bar is equal to the maximum amplitude A times the sine of omega times the time t plus a phase angle alpha. Therefore we can conclude that a body with the mass m suspended on the spring with the spring constant k performs a simple harmonic motion around its equilibrium position shifted by the distance of m times the magnitude of the gravitational acceleration g divided by k. If the mass of the spring is not negligible but small compared to the mass of the body, then each part of the spring performing a harmonic motion with different acceleration has to be taken into account in the fundamental equation of dynamics. The greater the distance of a given part of the spring from the body is, the smaller the amplitude of its oscillation is, and this effect modifies the motion of the body as well. For such a problem, it is easier to derive the equation of motion from the law of the conservation of energy instead of applying the fundamental equation of dynamics. Here we only show the resulting equation since the details of its derivation can be discussed after the introduction of the concept of energy and the presentation of the law of its conservation. Then the equation of motion states that the quantity of the mass m of the body plus the mass ms of the spring divided by 3, times the second order derivative of the displacement x bar is equal to minus the spring constant k times the displacement x bar. Here the factor m plus ms divided by 3 is called the reduced mass mr of the body, which can be written as m times the quantity of 1 plus the ratio of ms to 3 times m. We have the same equation of motion as in the case of the spring with the negligible mass, only with a reduced mass mr instead of the mass m of the body. Then the forms of the equations describing the kinematic quantities of the oscillation of the body remain the same, only the reduced mass has to be replaced with the mass m. For example, omega squared is equal to the spring constant k divided by the reduced mass mr, telling us that the angular frequency of the oscillation of the body is smaller than the angular frequency measured in the case with a spring of a negligible mass. As a result, the period t of the oscillation given by 2 pi times the square root of mr divided by k is greater than the period for the case of the spring with a negligible mass. Such a correction can be interpreted as the force F acting on the oscillating body with the mass m is smaller than k times x bar by the factor of 1 plus ms divided by 3 times m.